My name is Nick Leister, and I'm a member of the SolidWorks training team. In this multi-video series, I will show you how to start with SolidWorks as I model a pair of needle-nose pliers. In this video, the fifth in the series, I'll show you how to create an assembly that includes the pin and two instances of the handle. I'll also explore how mates constrain the motion of parts in an assembly. Let's get started. I'll start the assembly following a process similar to the one I used to start the parts. I'll click the New icon, which opens the new SolidWorks document window. From here, I'll click Assembly and click OK. An open pop-up and the Begin Assembly Property Manager appear automatically. I'll close the open window for now and scroll down within the Begin Assembly Property Manager. Under Fix Float Component on Insert, the option Only Fix First Component is selected by default. I'll discuss the significance of this option after adding parts to this assembly. I'll scroll up and click Browse, which opens the open window. Here, I see files on my local drive that I've saved to the platform, which brings up an important point of understanding about using the 3D Experience platform with SolidWorks. All designs, first saved to the 3D Experience platform, also save to a designated local drive automatically. However, if I first save to a local drive, in a folder that I choose, and then save the design to the platform, the design will not save here. After saving a design to the platform, it's not necessary to maintain a local copy. When you open the design from the platform, the software will download a new local copy here. Either way, it's always best practice to open your designs from the platform, which I will do using Open from 3D Experience. Now, I'll browse to my bookmarks. Under the Hand Tools, Pliers bookmark, I'll select Pin and click Open. I'll hover my cursor over the view area, which shows a preview. Clicking the keyboard's Enter key places the part. The assembly environment looks similar to the part environment, with a few exceptions. First, the Feature Manager design tree contains the parts within the assembly and a mates node at the bottom. Second, the Command Manager includes tabs geared explicitly for working with assemblies. However, the assembly environment user interface operates identically to the parts environment in most regards. For example, I'll change the units to inch pound second using the menu at the bottom. I'll also change the scene to a plain white background. Now, I'll add the handle components to this assembly. To do this, I'll click Insert Components from the Assembly tab of the Command Manager. I'll click Open from 3D Experience. Again, I'll click Bookmarks. Under Hand Tools, Pliers, I'll select Handle and click Open. The part moves with my cursor. I will use the middle mouse button to zoom out enough so that I can get some perspective. Earlier, I used the keyboard's Enter key to place the pin. However, I'll place the handle by clicking within the view area. Now, I'll click the F key to fit the model to the view area. I will add a second handle component to the assembly, and because I already have one, I'll hold the keyboard's Control key, hover the cursor over the handle's component, then click, hold, and drag to create a second instance of the handle. Finally, I'll release the cursor button and the Control key. The handle parts move when I click and drag. However, the pin stays in place when I try to move it. The pin does not move because it's fixed in place, as noted by the letter F in front of the part's name. On the other hand, the handle parts float and are unconstrained by mates, which is why they have a negative symbol in front of their part names. I'll change the pin state from fixed to float by right-clicking the pin from the Feature Manager design tree and then clicking Float. The pin now shows a negative symbol before its name, and I can click and drag it to move it around. Fixing a part is one way to constrain its movement in an assembly. Mates also constrain movement, but with greater precision. I'll constrain the pin's movement in this assembly by mating its origin to the assembly's origin. There are several ways to create mates. I'll start by demonstrating the process using a pop-up. To do this, I'll expand the pin part within the Feature Manager design tree, select the origin, and select the assembly's origin while holding the keyboard's Control key. This process allows me to select multiple tree items and opens a pop-up window. I'll select Coincident, which moves the pin's origin to the assembly's origin. The pin part no longer has a symbol before its name. It stays in place when I try to move it. Now, I'll constrain the handles to the pin's geometry with mates. Here, I'll use the mate command from the assembly tab of the command manager. I'll select the flat face of the pin first. Then, I'll select the flat face on one of the handles. A pop-up appears, displaying the mate types my selections support. I want these two faces to remain coincident, the default option. I'll use the pop-up and click OK. Moving the handle shows the nature of the coincident mate. The two faces are constrained to one another, but the handle maintains planar movement. Now, I'll define a concentric relation between the two cylindrical faces. I'll click Concentric from the Property Manager and select the pin cylindrical face and the handle cylindrical face. Again, I'll use the pop-up to click OK. The handle's position relative to the pin looks good. I'll click OK to close the Mate Property Manager. Moving the handle highlights the part's motion to its constraints. I'll use the pop-up method for creating mates to create a coincident relation between the handle's two flat faces. Once again, I'll hold the keyboard's control key and select the two flat faces to summon the mate relations pop-up. Here, I'll select coincident and the second handle moves to fit the relation, but I want the two selections to face one another in this case. So, I'll click the Flip Mate Alignment pop-up icon. Now, I'll create a concentric relation between the cylindrical face of the handle and the pin using an entirely different method. I'll drag the handle's cylindrical face close to that of the pin and hold the keyboard's Alt key. The handle snaps in place and an icon appears. The Mate Relations pop-up appears when I release the left mouse button and the Alt key. With concentric selected, I'll click OK. I'll test the movement, which behaves as I expected. Now that I know the parts fit together within the context of the assembly, I'll lock them so that no one else on my team can make changes to this design but me. To do this, I'll expand the Feature Manager Lifecycle tab and click the Padlock icon to toggle the lock status for both parts. I'll save this assembly to the platform by expanding the File menu dropdown and clicking Save to 3D Experience. The Save to 3D Experience pop-up window appears. I'll enter Needle Nose under SW Title. With Nicholas Workspace selected as my collaborative space, I'll browse to the Pliers bookmark using Select from Recent. Now I'll click Save. The Task Pane's 3D Experience tab shows that this assembly is unlocked. I'll select it and use the Collaboration tab at the bottom to toggle its lock status. Locking the assembly and the parts ensures that when I come back to the office tomorrow to detail this design further, the model will be exactly as it is now. Finally, I'll close the assembly. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access a complete SolidWorks CAD Fundamentals playlist.